Why is the sea salty? Say, do you know where I can get some fish? This sea doesn't seem to have any. Don't you know you're at the Dead Sea? The water is so salty that no fish or plants can live in it. I was wondering why there were no fish to eat. I've always wondered though, why are the seas and oceans so salty? All this actually begins with rain. Rainwater contains a little carbon dioxide absorbed from the surrounding air, making it slightly acidic in nature. What? Acidic? But I drink that water! It is only slightly acidic. It may not affect us. But when it rains down on rocks, it erodes them. All this erosion eventually ends up in our seas and oceans. This process creates electrically charged atoms, also known as ions. The two main ions created are chloride and sodium, and these are salty. Oh, I know sodium. It's in the salt we eat. But how does all this rainwater end up in our oceans and seas? Ah, that's where rivers and streams are very important. Rainwater runs off into streams and rivers, which eventually lead to the sea. Rivers are not as salty as the sea, as they deposit all of the dissolved salts into the seas and oceans on a regular basis. But water from oceans and seas also evaporates. Shouldn't that make them less salty? Evaporation makes seas saltier. Fresh water evaporates, leaving salt and dissolved minerals behind. It has taken millions of years of salt deposits and evaporation to make seas and oceans as salty as they are today. Most oceans and seas have rivers which flow out, carrying some of the salt with them. The Dead Sea has no rivers to remove salt, and because of that, it's even saltier than other oceans and seas. Whoa! I better go find another place to catch my lunch!